Hello and welcome to Vibe TV. I'm Gemma.
And I'm Scotty. And this is our brand spanking new show run by Edgehill students for the Edgehill community.
Vibe TV aims to bring Edgehill students info on news and events from on and around campus. So what's been happening so far?
A lot's been happening, from the opening of the new Arts Centre to live music nights in the venue. Firstly, let's talk Freshers' Fair.
There were societies there from Disney to volleyball. Did you know currently there are 74 societies at Edgehill?
When I was there, I took advantage of all the stores. I even got free pizza.
Our reporter Dom was on campus to investigate what was happening on the day.
Hi, I'm Dom Tolley and I'm here at Edgehill University for Vibe TV for the Edgehill University Freshers' Fair 2012. Let's go and see what they've been up to.
I'm here with Elliot, who's the SU president. So what have you been up to today?
Very, very busy is what I've been up to. I don't know, we've been manning this SU stall, telling students about the students' union. And also I've been going around all the societies, all our sort of commercial partners, basically ensuring that, and all the sports teams, ensuring that everyone's okay, ensuring that it's been a good day. So just getting around the place, getting ourselves out there, basically.
We play women's rugby, kind of in the name. You don't have to have had any experience to come and join us. Charlotte, you've never played, had you before?
No, I haven't.
We are more like a family than a team, really, because we spend all year together. We go to competitions.
We live really close to each other. Yeah. All houses.
We have socials. So it's a nice way to make a really close group of friends, keep active, and just do something different, because you might not be able to do it outside of university afterwards.
Hi, I'm here with Jacob from the Medieval Reenactment Society. Have you got anything to say to the freshers joining this year?
If you want a really great society that it is completely out there compared to any other societies, we're the one to go to. We're fun, we're different, exercise, it's amazing.
I'm here with Kelsey from Edgehill Musical Theatre.
It's opportunities for musical directors, people who play instruments, people who do set and lighting design, so it's something for everyone really.
It sounds a lot geekier than it actually is. It's just for anyone who has a vague interest in history of any kind. If you're just really interested in maybe 20th century stuff, if you like the films all about it or anything, we get together, we have film nights, we have quiz nights, we go on holidays, educational trips. And we have lots of socials, so it is good, it's really fun.
I'm here with Stephen from Vibe Media, and he's going to tell us a little bit about what they're doing.
Yep, so we are Vibe Media. It's Edgehill's brand new media collaboration. The online thing is involving all the news. It's got up-to-date radio, which is they broadcast 10 till 10 every single day. We've got the TV crew, we've got the magazine as well, which is all different feature articles, which is fantastic. All upon vibemedia.co. If everyone logs onto there, they can see all the up-to-date news, breaking news, and everything like that.
Hello, this is the Doctor and this is Captain Jack. We're from the Doctor Who Society. If you want to come along and be join all fellow Whovians, then sign up, have a great year and be ready for a trip of a lifetime.
So, as another Edgehill Freshers' Fair comes to a close, I've been Dom Tolley for Vibe TV. Thanks for watching.
Freshers' Fair was all about the students starting this year, but what about prospective students starting next year?
Open days offer the potential students opportunities to see what's on campus, grab free food and get a feel for their courses.
They give a great opportunity to see the facilities as well as providing a sneak peek of uni life.
Our reporter Lewis was on campus to interview visitors, students and staff.
Hi and welcome to Vibe TV. I'm Lewis Kitchen and I'm joined today in the Hale Hall with the new and upcoming prospective recruits to Edgehill University who are registering for their open day.
Have you got a prospectus?
No, I haven't.
Hi, I'm joined by Alex Illingworth today, our Edgehill Student Union Vice President. So Alex, what are you hoping to get out of today?
Just really talk to prospective students, show them what Edgehill's all about, and specifically what the Student Union can offer to them if they come here.
And what are our prospective students going to get out of today?
Well, it's a really good opportunity to talk to course tutors, learn about the subject, how it differs from other universities, talk about the accommodation, have a look around, have a look at the beautiful campus. And then sort of speak to us, find out about sports, societies, all that sort of stuff, what they can get involved in if they choose Edgehill.
Hello, Chris and Louise.
Hi.
Hello.
Okay, what made you come and visit Edgehill today?
I've been to quite a few universities and none of them I really liked. I hadn't been anywhere that I really liked and I wanted somewhere, I've got somewhere in mind as kind of like first choice, but I wanted somewhere as like kind of a backup, but coming here, I think, I don't know, it could be like my first choice now. I really like it.
What's your hope to get out of the open day today?
It's really good. It's helpful.
Do you think
so? Yeah.
Do you find the organisation quite well and people getting shown around?
Yeah, it's like you're in this room wherever you want to go and ask anyone you want.
Yeah. Is Edgil your first choice?
Yeah.
So you can't wait to get all excited and moving on up, yeah?
Yeah.
Next step toward adulthood. Yeah. Hi, Don.
Hi.
How are you doing?
I'm fine, thank you.
Thank you very much. So what have you been doing today at Edgil?
Well, we've been showing prospective students around the campus. We've been supporting, telling exactly what we're doing for media courses, how we support students in our media studio here at Edge Hill, our HDTV studio. Hopefully they'll take away a good example of why we actually support students in this environment as well, and the actual build and the way we've actually adopted this studio so it actually replicates what they would find in industry.
So I've learned a hell of a lot today at Edge Hill's Open Day, and I'm looking forward to all the new students that are coming next year. My name's Lewis Kitchen, I'm here for Vibe TV, and you can check us out at www.vibemedia.co.
That was just one of our open days. You can look forward to more of those and more pizza throughout the year.
Yes, we can, Gemma. Edge Forward Dance Company performed a recent hub opening for the Duchess of Wessex. That's wicked.
This is the official opening of the hub, a place where people can meet, eat and shop on campus.
After putting in lots of effort, the hub was packed for the performance and the opening.
Our reporter Kira met dancers from Edge Forward and Hill Start.
To give Her Royal Highness the Countess of Wessex a warm welcome to Edge Hill University, Edge Forward Dance Company were invited to perform their piece Wingman in collaboration with Hill Start. Both companies are made up with second and third year students from the university's performing arts department, and I'm here with some of the dancers to ask them about their experiences.
The original piece Wingman is about male friendship. Our choreographer, Debbie Milner, wanted to create a piece that didn't look at sexuality or any of the things that people look at normally. And she wanted to just look at the relationships between men.
Essentially, Edge Forward already had the piece Wingman, and everyone else, like from Hill Start, and then there's some first year dancers as well, were just slotted into it. So we learned some of the phrases that Edge Forward learned for this, and then it all came together really. So we had a few rehearsals over a week to put it all together. And
alongside the choreography in itself, the spacing of the hub was quite a difficult situation because there were so many of us, and to put all of these people into such a small space and create the choreography in itself, I think that was quite difficult, and we had to rearrange some of the choreography and some duets that happened, and a few times some people had to hold back on what they originally did to enhance the performance in the space.
People can say that they have performed for a member of the royal family.
In itself, it's a privilege, and for the university, because to bring more people to the university and allow everyone to express what they're doing in the university and to showcase us as a university, as the different companies, Hill Start and Edge Forward, and then to say that we've performed to a member of the royal family.
So guys, if a first year student had watched your performance, looked at it and thought, wow, I really want to get involved in that, where would they go, what would they do?
There is an opportunity to go to society classes, then audition and perform with the company itself in your second and third year.
Guys, thank you very much for talking to us. I've been Kieran Millett, these guys have been Edge Forward and Hill Start, and we're signing off for Vibe TV.
I was there in the hub watching the opening. I'm so jealous that I didn't do dance.
Oh, me too. Here in the studio, we have Gareth Dowling, the Vice President of Arts and Sciences. Nice to have you on the show.
Thanks for having me in.
Gareth has been at every cantina that we've had so far.
So tell us a little bit about cantina.
Yeah, well, it was a bit of a collaborative effort between the some of the management in the university, the students' union, the bar, and some of the media department lecturers. You know, we've got more students than ever before living on campus, and there's very little opportunity given to them to socialise on campus at the weekend. So we thought, and we haven't had live bands here in an awful long time, so it's great to finally get a bit of live music back on and give them something to do on a Friday night.
Fantastic. So what's been your favourite act so far?
Well, I've seen about 9 or 10 different acts at this stage. And while I liked the majority of them, I think the Hummingbirds kind of really just stood out for me. They were great, you know, entertainers. The songs they played were really good. They played a really long set. They played about an hour and then came back on for another 10 or 15 minutes after we kind of pushed them back on stage. And even afterwards, they came down and did photographs and talking to people and everything. So Hummingbirds were definitely one of my favourite acts.
They were great, yeah. Hey, Carry On, the support act was really good too. Mm. Did you see them too?
Yeah, I saw them as well, and it was a great night altogether. So.
My favourite, Esco Williams, actually just won an award at the Mobos. He won the Unsung Artist Award.
It's great. We're just getting some really quality acts coming onto campus now. So.
So why should students go to Cantina instead of the other events on campus?
Well, like I say, during the week, it's packed out, you know, between sports clubs, training, matches, societies, and obviously coursework and that. So at the weekend, it's often been very, very quiet. So it's nice to finally give the on-campus students something to actually do at the weekend without having to go too far. There's not a lot of effort. You just have to walk down, it's quite cheap in general. And like I say, the acts are of real quality. And as you say, award-winning acts coming in. And we're seeing some of these Liverpool bands, coming onto the scene, getting onto Radio City and that, and possibly these could be the acts of the future.
So what is the future for Cantina?
Well, it was all kind of, thrown together in September there to make sure that we had something to offer. And given the success and the take-up that students have had of Cantina, it looks like, we should completely roll this out and keep going with it. The next step, I think, is looking at this Battle of the Bands concept, which is coming up in a couple of weeks' time, where we're looking at doing a Battle of the Bands in the venue to see what student bands will be able to get their own gigs or supporting acts for the Liverpool bands. So if there's any aspiring bands out there or any individuals that are members of bands, if they want to come into Students' Union, leave their details and a disc, they're more than welcome to be considered.
Did you hear that, bands? If you've got a band, Students' Union, go.
Don't be scared. If you want to see great live music from metal to R&B, come to the venue at Edgehill every Friday night.
Tickets just cost £2 with your student card.
So thanks for chatting with us, Gareth.
Very much.
As well as the opening of the Student Hub, Edgehill has also been celebrating the opening of the new Arts Centre.
An exciting lineup of acts playing in the Rose and Theatre Studios, including student and professional performances.
Kyla LaGrange came to the university to perform a new album, Ashes.
Kyla's song, Walk Through Walls, is also featured in Edgehill University's new promo video.
I met up with Kyla to talk to her about Ashes. Hi, I'm Gemma for Vibe TV. I'm here with Kyla LaGrange, who's opening the brand new Arts Centre at Edgehill Uni. So how would you describe your band's genre?
It's a bit of a mixture. It starts out with a lot of folk, and then there's a lot of rock and indie and pop influences, so yeah, it's all jumbled up together.
So when did you first start singing?
I don't really remember. I did it ever since I was little. I think I just always liked, I used to just hide behind the curtains when my parents had friends around and sing so they couldn't see me. I never like being watched, even now.
Where would you most like to perform anywhere in the world?
I've always wanted to perform in a cave because lots of my songs are very reverb-y and I always thought it would be nice to do like an a cappella gig in a cave.
Have you got maybe a hidden talent or a party trick?
Yeah, I do. I haven't done it for years though, so I don't know if I can still do it. But I can make a sound like a monkey, but like really like a monkey.
Thank you very much, Kyla. I've been Gemma for Vibe TV and that was Kyla LaGrange. So we just saw Kyla LaGrange at the Arts Centre, but not everything we do is on campus.
Vibe TV went to Camp and Furnace in Liverpool to see Edgehill tutor Mark Edwards perform as Gale Force in Council House Movie Star.
Kieran's got the report.
Do rock. come from theatre performance, contemporary dance, and I write for performance. I had very specific ideas of what I wanted in the film, and I wouldn't compromise on that,
yeah,
because that had to be the very strict narrative of this.
So Gail, what made you want to turn your story into this installation?
I was interested in looking at performativity, autobiography, I mean performing autoethnography, and I was wanting to bring my past and my childhood back, relive it, resurrect it, like resuscitate it, whatever you want. And I was quite persistent, I had integrity, I had this vision, and I wanted an exhibition installation that was immersive but not interactive. A shoot might be uncomfortable for people, mm-hmm, and it might be a bit intimidating for them to walk into this house and see these characters from everyday activity living. And it's more about a happening rather than performance. Mm-hmm. You know, it's been great working with Gary. I think it's fantastic that we've got this right in the Northwest, Liverpool, to celebrate queer, lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender performance, mm-hmm, art, and it brings that together with all the diverse practitioners that are out there.
Yeah.
And I think it's fantastic, you know, that we have that, and I'm very privileged to have been part of it this year.
So we may see a stage version of this in a few
years? You may see a stage version of it next year. I'm going to be going around Europe in a second-hand funeral house with Chris de Bray, The Death of Drag. I'm travelling all the way to Berlin.
Berlin?
Yeah, the roots of cabaret. Yeah. And restaging acts or routines or turns, I don't know if that word. Routine.
I've been Kieran Millett. She's been Gail Force.
And we're signing off for Vibe Media.
So that was Homotopia, our final report for the October show.
Finally, we have an exciting competition to announce. At the end of every Vibe TV broadcast, you have the opportunity to take part in our 168-hour competition.
You have a week to film, edit and submit a short film, around 5 minutes long. The theme for this episode's competition is Christmas.
The deadline for your submissions is 2 p.m. on Wednesday, the 22nd November, by emailing vibetv168@vibemedia.co.
The best entry will win a prize and be featured on the next show.
Good luck, and we look forward to seeing your entries.
This has been Vibe TV's first ever show. We hope you've enjoyed it.
On the next show, we'll have a roundup of what's been happening on campus over November and December,
including a Beatles and Queen tribute act, as well as much, much more.
I'm Scotty.
And I'm Gemma.
And we've been Vibe TV.